Channel 96.1, Brooke Morrison here with the iconic, legendary Big Boy.
Yo.
How you feeling today?
I'm super fantastic.
Yeah, you said you're busy today. What's been up?
We've been on tour, man. It's like the third leg, really the fourth stretch of the tour.
Okay.
Daddy Fat Sacks tour, and it's been great. Yeah.
At the Underground tonight, right?
Yeah, tonight we're at the
Underground. I will be there, and I'm super excited.
Oh, yeah, it's going
down. So tell me a little bit about Boomiverse, which dropped last summer.
Yep.
And I'm sure, which is why you're on tour at the moment.
Yeah, Boomiverse is like the newest album that I have out right now, and it is doing great. The new single is All Night. You know, Boomiverse is like the big boom. We cater to like the big bang.
Yeah.
It's the start of something new. Every time we make music, we cut into new territory.
Right.
And it's just that new Jedi rap music.
So what is, the process for a new project, especially being solo for you, which you've done two or three times before.
Yeah.
I believe, what has been different about this? I know you like to keep it unique.
Right. It's always got to be new. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. I mean, you always got to evolve, and it's not about recreating something that you've already done. It's always about making something refreshing and new for the people. You know what I mean? And that's, you know, how it can come out. And last for years because it's timeless.
Yeah, and I think not a lot of people know All Night was in the Apple emoji commercial.
Yeah.
Which blew up last year with the animated emojis and everything. So if you've heard that, you've heard part of his new project.
Yeah, I actually had about two or three songs in Apple commercials.
Yeah.
License Game on full tilt. Exactly.
You know,
Kill Jill is on the new Madden, and I got songs on the UFC fighting game. So the album is well saturated, and right now, with me teaming up with Hitco, we're just taking the world by storm right now.
Amazing.
Yeah.
So you rep Atlanta, and I know you love talking about rappers from the South and how it's kind of like a renaissance.
I don't be talking about them niggas.
No?
No.
You don't be talking about them?
Not them.
Well, I always hear that you say like the South is kind of like the new LA.
Oh, yeah. South in general, but not, you know what I'm saying?
Got you. Yeah. Okay. Well, you're not talking shit. I know you're not talking shit. Nobody's
not even talking shit, but I don't even be talking.
Right. So, I mean, what's different about the South versus the rest of the country when it comes to music?
I think in the South it's a certain level of brotherhood. You know, everybody works with everybody. Everybody knows everybody. You know what I mean? You might bump into whoever at a club and link up and vibe with them and bring them back to the studio and make music.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's all about unity. And I mean, as long as we stay unified, I mean, the boys going to keep running the ball.
So you're working on Superfly. I guess Superfly is coming out June 15th. So it's already been done.
Yep.
Was that filmed in Atlanta?
Yes, absolutely.
Yes.
It comes out June 15th. I'm in there playing Mayor Atkins, the mayor of Atlanta.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
I can definitely see you as a mayor. You look like a mayor type.
Man, the freaky, corrupt mayor of Atlanta.
Right.
Do I look freaky?
A little, yeah.
You know, I'm trying to tell you. For sure, you know what I'm saying? We slanging that yang around here.
Oh, my God.
All right.
No, I'm looking forward to seeing it. And I know you've done acting in the past,
yes.
Obviously.
Yes.
So do you have to switch gears usually when you start doing acting versus making music?
Yeah, I mean, it's basically, you know, you can... it's a lot of writing when it comes to music, but you know, acting, it's all about becoming that particular character and embodying yourself into that particular role.
Right.
So you kind of be in it, you know what I mean? So you kind of gotta cut it off and then become that person for a while you're doing that particular role to stay in it.
Nice. And I heard you actually audition for Stranger Things.
Yeah, man, I auditioned to be the Black Daddy. You know
that
I mean?
Would have been nuts, by the way.
Yeah, and I mean, but it would have been nuts, but he only had a breakfast scene. He didn't up and pull some cereal and look at the mama like, what you talking about? You know what I mean?
But so you've also said that if Stranger Things would have happened, you probably wouldn't have made Boomiverse. Is that true?
I probably could have did it with that shout ass scene. I would have still been able to do the album. I probably could have did that and went right back to the studio.
Exactly.
Maybe season 3.
Exactly. Oh, my gosh.
Might be the stepdad. I mean, I don't know.
No, I really hope you do, because I feel like that could definitely use like kind of like a southern, like offsetty type personality in the show.
I would set it off.
For sure.
Yeah.
Okay, listen. So I want to adopt a dog.
Okay.
And I know that you breed pit bulls.
Yeah, and Frenchies.
And Frenchies now. Yeah. I've been seeing that. They're adorable, by the way.
Yeah.
But I know it can get scary with adopting and like with breeders not being reputable and stuff like that. What do I need to look out for when trying to look for a dog?
You might want to kind of get references, maybe.
Okay.
You know, with us, we've been doing it over 20 years, you know.
Yeah, everybody
here. Unbelievable Bulldogs, Pitfall Kennel. Right. So, I mean, we've sold dogs from everybody from Serena Williams to 50 Cent, Rick Ross, Usher, Taraji P. Henson just brought a Frenchie named K-Ball that she made so famous.
Wow.
So, I mean, you just got to, you know, kind of see what the clientele looks like.
Right.
And then if you got a chance to go out and visit the facility, you can do that, too.
Cool.
Yeah.
You know what's funny is I actually tried to adopt a dog and I called And I was like, yo, I want this dog. It's super cute. It's adorable, whatever. And she told me, she was like, sorry, Jermaine Dupri just adopted this dog.
Oh, that's dope.
I know. I was like, what?
Yeah,
but
man.
First of all, I didn't know they were allowed to put out names like that. So that made me feel like, okay, well, maybe I shouldn't buy from you.
Right.
At the end of the day. But well, I was really sad.
Well, you can, I mean, you can. You know, I mean, you can. But people with us, they just know. You know what I'm saying?
Right. I get you.
Just depends.
And you have a lot of side stuff, a lot of side hustles, a lot of investments.
Yeah.
Which a lot of millennials, I guess my age,
right.
would really, really love to get into, but we have so little expendable income.
Right.
What advice would you have for people trying to invest, especially with so very little money?
Pay your taxes first.
Right.
And then after you do that, you see what you got left.
Right.
Just put your money into stuff that's going to make your money multiply. You know what I mean? I mean,
right.
the old rule is like, let your money work for you.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, you want to buy, you know, everybody wants to get the nice things, and you know, but after a while, you know, make sure you set aside something for your 401k or whatever you want, because, you know, we don't know how long y'all going to be making music.
Right.
Like, I mean, I've been doing this like now going on almost 25 years, so, and I had a chance to get the money, fuck it up, get it back, flip it again.
Right.
And so right now, music is recreational for me, so I'm just having fun living life.
And making those mistakes is a sign of a good businessman.
Yeah, but you better have some hits to get it back, though.
Exactly. Exactly. So out here in Charlotte, we're super big in NASCAR.
Yeah.
And I heard you did an investment in NASCAR. That
terrible investment
was terrible
for me.
Yeah. What happened with that?
Well, it was supposed to be me and the Wayans brothers and a couple other people. And I had some business managers. I, you know, threw like, you know, some money down on it.
Yeah.
Long story short, I've never been to a race. And I never got that return back.
I've never either. So,
yeah.
It's fine. So. I just moved here, though. So I'll go. I promise.
Yeah.
I don't
try to buy no team.
I will not.
Right.
I promise. Yeah. Okay, so what is up next for you? So you got the acting stuff, the music stuff. You're on tour tonight.
Yeah. What's next for me is I'm going on tour with Christina Aguilera in the fall.
What?
Yeah.
No way.
Yeah.
Has that been announced and I just haven't known about it? Like, that's crazy.
It sold out in like 2 days.
Wow.
Yeah, they announced it weeks ago, the Liberation Tour with Christina Aguilera.
That's crazy.
I'm going to Europe in June.
Nice.
And then my I have one son that's going to college in the fall and the other one that's a football player. And then we have a lot of school visits, you know, because he plays football.
Right.
And, you know, we're just being balancing family life and music and just really, you know, having fun every day of my life, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And one more question. I know I have to ask it, and I'm sorry. I apologize in advance. Pusha T and Drake. It happened last night.
Mm-hmm.
And I just want to know, from your standpoint, as far as beefs go in hip-hop, is that really, like, you know, it's such a big part of the culture that it's necessary to go at each other like that? And
I mean, it's some good old-fashioned rapping, man.
Yeah.
I mean,
who do you think is maybe has the leg up right now?
I don't know. I got to wait to see what else happened, but it's pretty good right now.
It is really good.
It's pretty good.
We got babies and baby mamas and all kinds of other stuff that's popping out of nowhere.
I don't know shit about that.
Right, right. Well, I'm excited to see you tonight. Thank you so much for sitting down with us, big boy.
Yeah.
Channel 96.1.
All right.